Here's an interesting question. Does drinking coffee actually dehydrate you? Being the kind of person who likes to read health books and health articles, and the kind of person who definitely enjoys a morning cup of coffee, I have heard this assertion many, many times. It's usually phrased this way: coffee is a diuretic, so it'll dehydrate you if you drink it. But is this actually true? Well, the short answer is, well, actually two short answers. One, yes, coffee, or rather the caffeine within that coffee, is technically a diuretic. But answer number two, no, it will not dehydrate you. For the most part, coffee will actually hydrate you just about as well as normal water will, especially if you take it with milk or cream. So given that, why are people continually running around talking about coffee as a diuretic? I imagine it's because people don't really know what the definition of a diuretic is. They probably think it's something that actively dehydrates you, which it's not. A diuretic is, by definition, just something that increases the production of urine. So if you're drinking something that is a diuretic, you have to consider that that's only one feature of that beverage. Another very important feature being the fact that it's probably mostly composed of water. This means that in order for a diuretic beverage to dehydrate you, that diuretic effect would have to be significantly powerful enough to offset the increase in water flowing into your body. And in the case of coffee, that diuretic effect isn't very strong at all. And what's more, if you drink coffee with any regularity whatsoever, your body develops a tolerance to that effect really quickly. A study that was done back in 1928 found that participants who abstained from caffeine for over 2 months did have a substantial fluid loss after being given caffeine, but within 4 to 5 days of regular caffeine use, their bodies developed that tolerance. And putting the case of coffee aside, most beverages that are diuretics that we drink in our everyday lives are in fact weak diuretics, which means that drinking them will hydrate you nearly as well as normal water will. In fact, a 2015 study that was done in the UK tested the fluid loss caused by 13 different drinks, including, and you and I both know I have an iPad here that I'm reading off of, so I'm just gonna read off of it, coffee, tea, lager beer, orange juice, soda, and milk. And the data they gained from these tests was used to create a beverage hydration index, which showed that all the tested drinks hydrate nearly as well as plain water. Coffee was the worst, but it was still pretty darn close. Also, surprisingly, milk was found to be even more hydrating than water, which is why earlier I said that if you take your coffee with milk or cream, it's probably right on par with water. So here's the bottom line. All the drinks you consume throughout your day contribute to your overall hydration. And this is also true of the food you eat, especially if you eat lots of water-heavy fruits and vegetables, which you definitely should be doing. Now, this definitely doesn't negate the other negative effects that certain drinks can have, though. You can still become caffeine dependent if you drink too much coffee or too many caffeinated beverages, and that can really interfere with the quality of your sleep and also impair mental functioning. And if you're drinking lots of sodas or those energy drinks, or even a lot of fruit juice, the sugar in those drinks can cause an excessive insulin response, which can lead to weight gain and all sorts of other health problems. So if you want to optimize your health, use common sense and make most of your fluid intake be either water or low caffeine teas like rooibos, not rooibos, but rooibos, and or green teas. Did I just say and or in a video? Also, a morning latte or a glass of orange juice won't hurt much either, as long as you keep these things in moderation. But from a hydration point of view, all of it counts. None of these drinks is going to dehydrate you. In fact, the ironic part in this is that the most potentially dehydrating part of coffee or any beverage with a diuretic effect is the fact that people tell other people that it's dehydrating. As the author Ben Desbrow put it, by advising people not to consume drinks they enjoy, just because they contain caffeine, individuals may not automatically replace drinks, leading to a reduction in total fluid intake. Now, if you want to learn more about hydration and figure out how you can make sure that you stay hydrated, stick around because that'll be the topic for next week's video. Until then, keep enjoying your morning coffee. Speaking of coffee, and moderation, the one time when my caffeine intake does tend to spike is when I'm editing my videos. And one of the most common questions I get about my editing process is, what tools do you use? Now, honestly, I use a lot of different programs to make my videos because my videos have a lot of different moving parts to them. But the two workhorse programs that get most of the heavy lifting done are Adobe's Premiere Pro and After Effects for Animations. Both of these programs are really powerful, but that also means that they can be pretty complex at the start, especially After Effects. I remember opening that for the first time, it was like trying to learn a new language just to use the interface. But eventually, through a lot of practice, I was able to learn the ins and outs of both programs, and they enabled me to now make far better videos than what I was putting out a few years ago. So if you're a budding YouTuber or you want to make your own videos, I highly recommend learning the ins and outs of both of these programs and learning them well. The proficiency will enable you to far better express your creativity. And if you happen to want to accelerate that learning process, you'll find a ton of great courses and tutorials over at Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning library with over 17,000 courses and topics ranging from photography to graphic design to web development and many, many more. And that includes tons of courses on both Premiere and After Effects animation. Now, while Skillshare has a huge amount of courses on both Premiere and After Effects, I do want to give you a couple of specific recommendations to get you started. The first one I'll recommend is Jordy Vanderput's complete course on Premiere Pro, which takes you all the way through the basics of the software and teaches you editing basics like color correction. Like this shot right now is color corrected. Now it's not. Now it is, and things like sound editing and lots of other techniques. And secondly, Jake Bartlett's course on animating with ease in After Effects is a great one. Now there are a ton of different skills you can learn in After Effects, but I think that easing, which is simply changing the speed of an animation along a curve rather than using linear motion, is one of the most fundamental and adds a ton of polish to my videos. So if you want to give Skillshare a try and check out those classes or any of the other on the platform, you can get 3 months of unlimited premium access for just 99 cents using the link in the description down below. But you definitely want to hurry because that deal only lasts until the end of January. After that, their premium subscription starts at less than 10 bucks a month, and of course, you can cancel at any time. I want to give a huge thanks to Skillshare for sponsoring this video and helping to support this channel, and as always, big thanks to you for watching as well. If you like this video, you can give it a like down below or share it with a friend if you think they'd find it useful, and you can also subscribe to my channel right there to get notifications of new videos when I release them. You can also click right there to get a free copy of my book on how to earn better grades, or click right there to watch one more video on this channel. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.